Hey guys, another video in my series of tutorials on Lightstream Studio One Mixer. This episode is going to be all about how to set up your overlay. And then the next episode, we'll be talking exclusively about alerts. So right now, we're just going to get the overlay. Let's get the overlay. If you're seeing this, that means everything is linked up. Your Lightstream is linked to your Mixer account. If you don't see this and you don't know how to get here, you might watch the video that I did right before this one. So what we have right here, this will be where your game is. We're gonna actually be able to add branding. You know, you can add your logos, you could add pictures, you could do so many different things here. So I'm gonna go over like how to get that set up. The first thing you'll see down here are scenes. The best way to think of a scene is it's a collection of these layers, right? So on my normal setup, I have a scene for right before I go live, like Modo is starting soon. I have one for when I'm live in my game that I'm playing. I have one for like, I need a bathroom break. It's my Be Right Back screen. I have another one for just when I'm talking and I'm not playing a game. It's just me talking. And then I have another scene for when I'm finishing my stream, my ending scene. So we're going to do a few sample scenes here just so you can get an idea of how it all works. Right here, the Mixer feed, I don't have it. I'm not currently streaming, but this would be your game or whatever you're streaming right here. Okay. So if you want to add to it, let's just start by adding. Let's start by adding a slideshow. Super simple. So go here, we go to slideshow, and I'm not gonna lie, this is actually the first time I have looked at this. Let's see here. Okay, so here's how it works. You have how long you want each image to show. So for me, I will say 7 seconds. How do I want those images to look? I think I want them to slide. Let's see, what do we have? We have roll. Wow. We actually have a lot of options here. I would say, well, let's just start with fade in and a fade out. We'll keep it super simple. The speed 1 second on the fade in, fade out. Loop delay. I don't want to delay that loop. I want it to just be continuous. I don't want these to be random. I want them to be controlled. Okay. So here we go. We just click that. We're going to go to upload image. And I'm going to say from my computer, I want to choose my files. I'm going to select the files on my computer that I want to upload here. Now, I'm not showing you this part just because it's not really necessary. So I chose 5 images, and I want to upload all 5 of these. So I just upload them here. Okay, so there we go. This is my very first time doing this. I am learning as I go. So now we have these images here in our slideshow. You can see them. They're already, cycling through. I don't want it this big. Well, I do want to make sure I keep it in the right aspect ratio. Move back. Yeah, so I do want to make sure. I think I'll just do it like this. I want to do this maybe 250 by 250 like that. Keep it square, nice and square. I'll put it up here. Okay, now that I'm looking at it, you know, that's actually that's still a little too big. So let's actually just do like 150 by 150. As I don't want it to take up too much of the screen, right? So we have a little slider here. I'll just put it like right there, right? Okay, so we have that done. This is our Mixer feed. So this is our game or whatever video we're streaming. So now this layer is our slideshow. We can rename it. I'll just call it, you know, promo slide. Okay, that's on top of this layer. If it was underneath it, you wouldn't be able to see it. So it's one thing you have to keep in mind is your layers. So let's see, what do we want? I'm not going to add a camera today, but that is how you could add a camera. You can also add the camera on your, like if you're streaming from your Xbox One, you could do the camera on that side. You don't have to do this. So one thing that's really cool is that Lightstream has a few built-in templates. Like if you're not artistic or you feel like, you know, you're not sure what to do or you don't have software to do it, they have a few in here. Now, I would like to see more, and I'm sure we will see more as they go. You can see down here, they've got some like basic overlays. Like this is a be right back. Thanks for watching, you know, at the end. Here's one that will do a little border around your camera, or just like a simple, you just click it and look. You have like a little simple border here, like Mixer branded. Now you see this is now covering my slideshow, which is not cool, right? All you gotta do is just bring it down. You just drag it. Or no, you don't drag it. What do you do? Oh, do you do this? Yeah. There you go. There, you drag it like that. You just grab it here and drag it. Like I said, this is my first time to ever actually see this. And you can add anything you want. I mean, you can just go in. Like, I want to start another scene. Let's see. Let's name it Be Right Back. All right. Name it Be Right Back. And we're on it. Duh. So I want to put an image there for my Be Right Back. So I think I'm going to upload another image because, you know, I'm not really digging that Be Right Back. I think I want something of my own. So I'm going to upload another picture. Okay, so I have actually uploaded two images that I had already made outside of this, and I just uploaded them here. Later on, we'll go in and I'll show you how to add alerts, and you can add other things to this, but you can see right here, it's just a basic Be Right Back screen, like Moto, we'll be right back. This is our scene with our stream, and you can just go in and you can add, you know, if you want to add another image, let's say I wanted to add, let's do another slideshow, for example. I've got these two images that I often use. I don't always have all these things running, of course, at once, because it can be, you don't want to do too much, right? So I'm going to upload a couple more images, a different slideshow. I'm going to leave these on for like longer. I want them to stay up a little longer so people have time to read them. And let's have them slide in left. Okay, and then let's see how that looks. I waited too long. Yeah, I want it to slide in left, and let's see what happens if you do slide out right. It might be too much. You never know. You gotta play with these things and just see. So that would be something that I could put up in this corner, you know, lets everyone know that this is my club. This is my Xbox club. You can find me here. This is my gamer tag. You can, you know, follow me. It does help. So, wait, I don't like that slide. That looks weird. So we're going to have to fix that. So let's see. Let's go back into settings. Do we want to do fade? We could try a couple. Let's do zoom in. Zoom in, zoom out. That might look cool. What else? So we got image. You could add just one image, the camera, third-party integrations. We are going to get into this in the next video. If you hit image and you go down here and you can see they have like the Be Right Backs that are standard. They've got a few here. You can click down here just a little further, you'll see more overlays. And here you can see they've got some creative overlays for like, let's say art and cooking. And you can see like the examples of those overlays. And then you can go back. They've got a few video game ones. I'm hoping they add more to these. For example, like Overwatch, that'd probably be a popular one. So then you have a little section for your donator. You have a pick for your cam. You have these other little elements. Yeah. So what's nice is that you can pick and choose the element and you're not locked into having the whole thing. So if you don't want the donate or you don't want the face cam outline, it's nice that you get the option that you don't have to. Let's do some text. I haven't done this. Let's see. let's do a different font. Let's go with, you know, I tend to use Oswald a lot. We'll do that. And then we can put some text in right here. We'll see. We'll do it at 35 white. Oh, wow. You can center it. You can, you know, justify it, bold it. You can scroll the text. That's super nice. You can add a background to it. There we go. Let's see. Add me as. Let's do like this. Add me as a fave on Xbox. Right? That's something you see a lot. So then let's say we get it typed. We go, maybe you want it down here in the middle. And you're like, you're having trouble centering. So you could just center it like that. You know, eyeball it about where you think. There you go. So then you've got text added. So the big thing to take note is just to really watch and make sure you have your layers in the correct order. Almost always are going to want your mixer feed on the bottom. That way, all of these other elements that you add will show on top. There's so many different things you can do. Another cool thing you can do with images is you can drop the opacity down. This particular image, it doesn't work out so great. But let's say, for example, you put up, let's say you have this image here, you know, tip me for free. And you don't want it to be so bright. So you can go here and you can reduce the transparency a little, you know, and you can kind of fade it. And that way the gameplay sort of bleeds through and it's not so bold and out there and bright. So that's an option you can do. I really like all the different options. Okay, so for the next video, we are going to talk about the third-party integrations. This will be very interesting. I am pretty much going to focus only on Streamlabs, but you'll be able to, you know, learn all of them. So I hope that answers any questions about the overlays and adding text and images and slideshows. I have found when you're doing these things, it's easiest if you just start off simple, and then as you stream and you get more comfortable with the software, then you add a little more. And obviously you don't want to go crazy anyways, right? Because too much on a screen can make people go bonkers. But everybody has their own style. I just recommend making sure any text that you put on your stream, make sure it's big enough that they can read it, but not so big that it detracts from the game you're playing or what you're doing, all right? Thanks so much. If you like these videos, I hope you give me a like and subscribe here on YouTube. And you're more than welcome to ever, you know, just stop by my streams over on Mixer. I'm at mixer.com/moto. And we love meeting new peeps. So I'd love to see you come over and say hi. Thanks so much.